ioneer is Bernard Rowe. Bernard, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Andrew.
Good to see you, Bernard. An EGM held today to approve the issue of stock here to Sibanye. This relates to the $70 million placement. How was shareholder support?
Very, very strong, Andrew. I'm pleased to report. We had a really strong vote, which is always good when you have an EGM or an AGM to actually have the shareholders engage and vote and let the board and the directors know the intention of the shareholders. In this case, we had over 600 million shares voting, which is approximately a third of our register. We had 99% of those votes were in favour of the resolution to place stock, as you mentioned, $70 million, so just a bit under 100 million Australian dollars to Sibanye, meaning that Sibanye will become, one of our larger shareholders with around about 7.5% of the company.
Tell us a bit more, Bernard, as far as the announcement yesterday, this approval here from the South African Reserve Bank. This relates to the overall strategic investment here, does it?
Yes, that's right. So there's several parts to the deal that we announced with Sibanye, back a month or so ago. The placement and the EGM vote today was about one of those parts, but really there's three parts to it. Yesterday's announcement, which was the approval from the South African Reserve Bank Board, or SARB, was approval about sort of Sibanye investing, in a foreign entity, in ioneer, and a foreign project in Rhyolite Ridge. Now, those three parts of the deal are the placement of $70 million, which has now been done. There's the $490 million that's going US, $490 million US dollars that's going in to the joint venture company. So there'll be a joint venture company set up. The Rhyolite Ridge South Basin will go into that project from ioneer. We own 100% of it. It'll go into that joint venture. Sibanye will put $490 million US dollars into that joint venture company. Ioneer will operate that joint venture company. So that's the second part. And the third part is the North Basin, which is an area that lies to the north of the main Rhyolite Ridge project. Sibanye have an option that we, ioneer, granted them that can come into the joint venture at a later date upon exercise of their option. And that would mean a contribution from them of a further $50 million into the joint venture. So you've got $70 million US coming into ioneer, and you've got effectively, up to $540 million coming into the joint venture company for a total investment from Sibanye, potential investment of $610 million US dollars, or roughly 830 million Australian dollars.
Tell me a bit more, Bernard, about the North Basin. Why is that currently outside of the JV? Are we talking similar lithium and boron mineralization here?
Yes, we are, and that's a good question. Andrew, yourself, I don't often talk about the North Basin. It's not something that we've really focused on because we've been very, very laser focused on completing the feasibility study, the piloting, and the strategic partnering process that will put in place the capital, the $800 million to build the South Basin project as it's defined in the feasibility study. The North Basin, as the name implies, lies to the north. It's actually contiguous, so it's not a separate block of claims. It's a contiguous area, but it's geologically separate. It's about 2 to 5 kilometers away, to the north of the main Rhyolite Ridge project. The geology there is similar, but it's not continuous geology between the two areas. So there are sedimentary rocks that host lithium and boron mineralization, similar in style, but not identical in style to what we have at the South Basin. We've only drilled two holes there, but Rio Tinto drilled quite a few holes there about 30 to 35 years ago, and we have that data. And so we know that there's a very, very large exploration target that we've calculated and published previously there. We know that there's a thick sequence of lithium and boron bearing sediments there. well north of 1 billion tonnes for an exploration target. And the reason that's not in the joint venture is simply, to begin with, is simply because we're still doing work on there, on that project, and we're going to continue doing that work now and ramp it up, in fact. And so that Sibanye will have the information that they require to make a decision on whether that gets folded into the joint venture.
And I see you've also, Bernard, you've had your quarterly out this week. The deal here with Sibanye, rounding off quite a transformational period for ioneer.
Yeah, absolutely it is. There's no question about that. I would characterise the deal with Sibanye as transformational for ioneer. It's the culmination of 5 years of work, well over $100 million of expenditure to do the pre-feasibility, feasibility, piloting, and all that goes with that, all the work that we've done. The deal with Sibanye is the culmination of all of that. And, you know, let me say that, you know, from what we've seen, Sibanye will be a fantastic partner for ioneer, very, very aligned on all relevant issues to this project, ESG, technical issues, mining, et cetera, experience that they bring to the table. And ultimately, both of us focused on the sustainable production of metals for the battery industry, particularly focused on US domestic supply.
So what's the focus for you, Bernard, between now and the end of the year?
So we're continuing to work on a few things. We've said previously, and we gave a brief update in the quarterly, that we're continuing to push ahead and we intend to list the company in the US. So we're just finishing the documentation around that. That's a process, so we have to submit all the documents, but we're soon going to be doing that and moving ahead with that. We're continuing to advance our offtake discussions. You know, I think we are looking through a slightly different lens now that we have the large part of the project financing addressed through that deal with Sibanye. So we are looking at things through a different lens, and we want to be very, very strategic with the next offtake agreement that we do. You know, we realise just, and as do Sibanye, just how important this project is for US domestic supply. And we want to make sure that as much as possible as what we produce in terms of the lithium, whether it be carbonate or hydroxide, is actually directly fed into the US lithium-ion battery industry that will power electric vehicles that will be produced in the United States. So they're the key areas. Look, we're doing some other things around continuing the engineering and awarding contracts, et cetera, as we've been doing. And lastly, I would say just progressing the permitting. We've got two out of the three permits. There's one more, the federal permit, that's the focus for us. So we'll be pushing ahead with that as well.
You and I, Bernard, we haven't spoken since the morning you announced the deal here with Sibanye. Clearly, on the back of what you said a bit earlier, strong shareholder support. What about the market? How's the market reaction been? Do you reckon it fully understands just how significant this is here for ioneer?
Oh, I think it's taken a little bit of time for the market to digest it. There's no doubt that ioneer is selling 50% of this project to Sibanye. And so I think, some in the market have taken a little bit of time to get their head around, well, why would you want to do that? With such a fantastic asset, why would you want to sell 50% to someone else? And the simple answer to that is this project is an $800 million US CapEx project, okay? And until we build that project, there's no cash flows, there's no revenues. And so the financing of the project is a big part of the equation and a big part of the risk that has to be addressed. I mean, what we've been doing over the last few years, when you look at it and boil it all down, is de-risking this project from a mining perspective, from a sales and marketing perspective, from an environmental perspective. All the work we've been doing is at the end of the day about being prepared to commence building and construction and de-risk. And financing is one area that there's a lot of risk. It's not easy for a single asset company to fund an $800 million project. And I would say there were plenty of people who thought that it would be near impossible for ioneer to do that only probably a year ago. But here we find ourselves today that we've actually got all the equity that's required to build the project. And we have, a tremendous partner. And together with that tremendous partner, we will put the remaining funding in place, which will be debt. So with the combination of the 490 plus the debt that Sibanye will assist us in arranging, this project is funded for the $800 million. And that's why our board took the decision that it was a sensible and very smart decision to sell down a stake in the project. It's a large stake, yes, but ioneer maintains operatorship. And the project is de-risked from a funding perspective, and this will get built.
Good to see you, Bernard. As always, thanks very much.
Thank you, Andrew. Pleasure.